Hey everyone, welcome to Up to Speed. I've got Nicki Palmer joining us today. Nicki leads our technology and product development team. Nicki, thanks so much for joining us.
Great to be here. Thanks, Katie.
All right, so a few exciting things happening with your team these days, but let's start with the one we're making some news about today. So real-time kinematics as it pertains to hyper-precise location services. That is a mouthful. I got it out. But tell me, what does that mean?
Yeah, you got it right, Katie. So we're announcing that we are deploying RTK technology at scale. And what RTK really is it's precision level accuracy and location technology. So we can find things, devices, IoT devices, ultimately smartphones down to centimeter level accuracy. So that compares with like a GPS alone level accuracy of a few meters today. So it is a big leapfrog in capability. And, you know, I'll tell you, for those of you that may be familiar with RTK, you may say, well, the technology itself has been around a while. And that is true. But in typical Verizon fashion, what we do best is find good technologies and figure out how to scale them for maximum benefit. And that is exactly what's happening here. Jean McManus on Sandy Gita's team, her and her team have been working on this for a while and have figured out the best way to deploy this technology. And it's by using our network, surprise, right? Leveraging the best asset that we have, our vast cellular network. So we're able to put these location stations at certain cell sites where we already have power, we already have backhaul, so they're connected to the network. And that's what we're announcing today. We're announcing that we're doing that. We're doing it at scale. And that's what has not been able to happen with this technology in different point deployments in the past. So this is good news. It's good news for every industry vertical, in fact.
So kind of great transition to my next question, which is, so what types of solutions or advancements does this technology enable?
Right. So the obvious one that everyone likes to think about and talk about is autonomous vehicles, right? And self-driving cars. And certainly this is an underlying building block for that. In fact, when Tammy's team in VBG and Andreas Orlando, when they respond to RFPs from car manufacturers, they are able to say, hey, this is our path forward to that. We have this great precision level location technology embedded in our network, and here's how we evolve that. And that's a game changer. So the OEMs, they want to know about that, and we're able to be industry leaders in the way that we're approaching this. So that's certainly one, and that will take time to evolve, as we all know. But if you think about high-value shipping or precision agricultural technology, or our drone business, for example. And, you know, there are so many places where this type of precision location can really help with an industry, but also with safety and security. So it affects a variety of things. In fact, we're happy to be providing this enablement to Elise Neal's group in the new business development side. And so she has a drone business, she has a precision a location business, and this gives her new capabilities to grow those businesses. So we can see it's helping our new business development and also our existing businesses with customers in the Verizon business group that want to, you know, continue to use 5G edge technology and now precision location to sort of enable new things in their business.
So Nicki, speaking of 5G, how does the 5G network play into this technology?
Yeah, well, I mean, think of our 5G technology and the millimeter wave just driving massive bandwidth, speeds, throughputs, our edge, our mech deployments that we just announced. So, you know, super exciting there. Being able to take, you know, pushing cloud to the edge, massive capabilities, the 8 currencies we talk about with 5G, add to this RTK as a building block, and you can start to see how you can pull all of these currencies and capabilities together to develop new solutions for businesses and consumers alike. So it's a building block.
Lots of good stuff to come there, I'm sure. So, Nicki, the last time you were with us on Up to Speed, we talked about the start of our Build the Future Challenge. And since then, we've identified some top submissions and projects. So can you give us a quick update? You know, what's happening with the winners and the ideas that were part of that event?
Well, I got to tell you, it was a massive success. And the Verizon employees, they just came through. The innovation and just like, you know, the forethought, the creativity that came through in over 1,400 submissions was amazing. And you really put the employees, you really put the team through their paces, you know, going through all of these because it was a lot. But they loved it. And as business leaders, we are loving it because we are harnessing that, these ideas. So, yes, we have winners. The winners' ideas are amazing. In fact, the three winners just presented their ideas to Kyle Malady and Ronan Dunn and Tammy Irwin just this past week. So they got that exposure and the whole leadership team is very excited about the new innovations that are happening here. So those winners are moving on to prototype. So, you know, now's the even harder work, right, where we do business cases and prototyping and, you know, see if these ideas can really scale. But they're on the fast track, so to speak, and lots of attention on these great ideas. And by the way, 1,400 plus submissions, you know, those don't disappear either. There's a lot of good ones, not just the winners. So a lot of great ideas in there that the business, you know, leaders that own those functions are also looking at for potential ideas and products. So it's great. I'm so excited.
We actually caught up with Katie Davis, one of the winners, to talk about the inspiration behind her project. Take a look.
Anyone with a cell phone can tell you that there are a lot of robocalls out there. Now imagine your business or emergency services getting flooded with robocallers, and you need to be able to pick up these real calls quickly to help the people who depend on you. I work in voice protection and analytics, and I've seen too many people come asking for answers. My team, Hans Van Arkel and Sean McGowan, and I, we came up with a network-level solution, Voice Defense Plus. But what really was the catalyst for this idea getting traction? Because bad actors love to take advantage of fear, chaos, and change. Being able to institute Voice Defense Plus will make sure that a critical channel for communication is safer and more efficient on Verizon's network than anywhere else. Technology and the people who believed in me got me to where I am today. I grew up in a really rural small town and technology opened up the world to me. I am one of those people who can't take without giving back for the next person. So if I can create something so someone can make a call when they need it most, it's my responsibility to help them like so many people have helped me.
Wow. I what I love about Katie and the Voice Defense Plus is that, you know, that team took an area of the business that they were already working on and sort of extended it in a new way. And we saw this over and over again with the challenge is that some ideas were really like blue sky, you know, as we think of like, you know, an ideation challenge, you think of these, you know, crazy way off ideas, and some of them were that far reaching. And, you know, those are important too, to challenge our thinking and push ourselves. But some are more like mini extensions of what we already do. And I the whole team was so impressed with how, you know, just the variety of ideas and the ingenuity of our employees to just push for the right reasons. So, yeah, it's great. Katie and the team, I'm psyched about that one.
Yeah, and you know, to that point, Nicki, you know, we've had a free robocall app in the market for a while now. So, you know, how do you see, you know, things like that that are already existing and then ideas like this kind of coming together, working together to advance us further?
Yeah, no, that's part of the beauty, as I was mentioning. I mean, some of these, you know, these products, robocalling is a problem in the industry, and we have put a lot of protections for consumers in place, products for consumers in place to help with this general issue and provide like safety and security and really be a trusted provider, uphold our brand to consumers. And bringing that to businesses in a new way is really, really exciting. So I think these things just layer on each other. And that's almost, I mean, sometimes the dirty little secret of product development is that it's not always the new shiny thing that's out there. It can be, and it is sometimes, but it is also taking what we have and evolving it in new ways, you know, using the assets we have, the talent we have in this organization and Verizon at large, which is unbelievable, and, you know, pushing it forward to help a different, solve a different problem or help a different, you know, customer base. And that's kind of what this is. And I think it's marvelous.
So, you know, Nicki, the great ideas don't end with the Build the Future Challenge. What else has the team been up to?
Well, I tell you, I mean, you know, I am so proud of the team to be able to continue delivering on commitments for products and services amidst working from home, the pandemic, and everything that's going on in our world. So I know other leaders have said it. I echo those comments and wanted to say it as well. But ideation can still occur through a computer and on a blue jeans call. And as evidence of that, we just had a hackathon. And I just, at my staff meeting yesterday, we reviewed and I got a great presentation from the winners of the hackathon. And these folks gave up their whole weekend to come up with a new way to solve a problem. And the problem had to do with how we measure, detect, and analyze devices in the IoT space and provide better tools to customers. And the idea is fantastic. And they worked all weekend on it and they've got a prototype out and we're going to take it and keep building off that. So the hackathon's another way, but I'm here to tell you that innovation is alive and well at Verizon.
Well, I probably can't come up with a better close to our conversation than that. So, Nicki, I will thank you for joining us for Up to Speed today. Everyone have a great
pleasure.
Thursday. Until next time, you are up to speed.